brain injury, the fall was July 19 last year.
2020.
He hit his head on, you know, on the floor, and within a minute, I heard it. I lifted his head. He was unconscious. I lifted his head. There's already blood coming from the ear and the left side of the head. And so rushed him to the trauma center in San Diego.
And then how long was he in a coma?
1 week. He was induced coma. He had craniotomy. And the left bone was removed for a good, from July to October, November.
So after the treatment, the first thing I noticed was just kind of more endurance during the few days afterwards. And we actually took a road trip down, you know, down Florida, down to Miami. And he was engaged and awake the whole time, not as moody and stuff. And even at the end of the day, coming back up to the hotel, a good 45 minute drive, nighttime, he was still aware, kind of checking things out, looking around. Mm-hmm. Whereas before he'd be passing out and like just dozing off.
So he sits up more upright and straight, and he can actually adjust himself by himself. But once he's sitting, say at the bright, at the edge of the bed, we can leave him. And he can actually like stay seated.
Yeah.
And before what would happen?
Before he would fall. Would
he
fall
like
to either the left or the right.
Mm-hmm. He's able to tell us more what is, you know, painful to him, and that's big, because before we kind of have to guess and kind of look at his behavior or other things he's saying. And so us being able to know like, oh, that hurts or it hurts there is a big